spin.
The sycamore.
Now, don't worry, folks. He has done this before. Dave Phillips would have to be one of the premier tiger moth aerobatic pilots in the country when he's not flying airliners or Victoria.
Oh, no, there's a beautiful thing, the blue nose. Rolls Royce Avon engine. Pleasure and privilege of doing that in a tiger moth, Graham, and indeed, as the key, if you own one, having a sort of circulator. It's wonderful to do the aerobatic sim.
Absolutely wonderful. You really know you're flying. Somebody once said to me, you know, it's the pure joy of flying, just can't beat the tiger. From my perspective, and I'd say it comes pretty close.
Sky. When you look at something like the Mustang or the Act 3 doing loops in like, you know, over 2,500 feet, the airplane is in total control. Dave knows exactly what he's doing, but it appears to be totally out of control. And there he recovers. Is that fantastic or what? Dave's actually a second generation tiger moth pilot. His father was a tiger moth crop duster pilot back in the 50s and 60s. So he grew up with these airplanes. He's been basically always never very far from a tiger moth since he was a child. And I think it's fair to say that shows. I've been flying tiger moths for 30 years and I've never seen anyone fly a tiger like Dave Phillips.
Magnificent spectacle.
Look at that, totally flat turn, no aileron whatsoever. No bank for this, we're totally flat turn.
I remember aerodynamics for beginners, airplanes aren't supposed to do that.
No.
You're probably seeing manoeuvres in terms of the proximity to the ground that are very close to those that would have been undertaken by the first generation. Imagine a whole lot of the nitrogen pouring out the back.
What we're seeing now is a very severe side slip, washing that lift off those wings by crossing the controls and leaving the airplane to fall almost sideways to the ground, but under total control. Look at that.
You've seen a stunning display, ladies and gentlemen. Airmanship of the highest quality. Dave Phillips.
I don't want to labour the point here, but you won't see anyone fly a tiger moth like that anywhere on the planet, as far as I know. Certainly I've never met anyone in Australia or New Zealand who can put on anything like anything vaguely approaching the tiger display that Dave does. Definitely it's a great treat to see that.
Well, you heard it from the big O. That's something unique in the world. Not seeing another 7 aircraft that you won't see anywhere either. Dave Phillips, ladies and gentlemen. Put your hands together.